very much. My pleasure to introduce contestant number two, Glenn Rogers. Exercise and aging. Exercise and aging, Glenn Rogers.
Madam Chair, fellow Toastmasters, and most welcome guests. I'm here tonight to make just one small point. One point that I hope many of you here will leave believing more so than when you came in here. It's not a point that everybody will believe. It is a very simple one, and that is that we need to do more exercise as we age, not less. Again, more exercise as we age, not less. I want to cover three areas of this. First, I'm just going to give you a little personal background. Then I'm going to give you some research information that I found. And lastly, I'm going to talk about how it can be done. So just as a personal background. So here I it's a few years ago now, and I'm just coming into my 30s. And my metabolism is starting to slow down. I just don't have to get up and go like I used to. You know, my muscles are just starting to deteriorate a bit. I go to the gym and they just not popping out the way they used to. So I thought, I guess I'm just getting old. I was feeling a little older, certainly. I thought, well, I guess I'll just stop all this exercise and stuff and I'll just get. Well, you know, by the time I reached 220 pounds, which is pretty wide for somebody my height, and you know, plus by just feeling worse and worse all the way through, I thought, well, maybe I should try something different. So I thought I would start to do more exercise. And I started walking, I picked up jogging, and I was biking. I thought skiing and winter's pretty darn nice. So it actually ended up working out really well. I'm starting to feel much better. I'm starting to feel fresher and younger. Oh my, this exercise thing is working out. So what I did is I ended up moving on to do a little research. And what I found is that there's actually lots of research on exercise and the benefits of exercise, and specifically about aging. So, of course, you know, at the very first level, we feel better. Physically, we feel better. We feel fresher, able to move easier. Emotionally, we feel happier. We have less anger, and just overall, we just feel better. And cognitively, we think clearer, right? We remember things more, and our mind is just younger. At another slightly deeper level of the research, we find that diseases are greatly prevented or held back simply by doing more exercise. There are various cancers which are prevented or prolonged. Diabetes is held off much, much longer, if you even get it at all. Arthritis, which runs rampant in my family, and I started feeling in my 30s. I don't have any of that anymore. None of it. It helps prevent dementia. Now, at a deeper level of research, it's been discovered that biologically, we simply don't age as quickly when we exercise more. There was research done in the last couple of years with 6,500 participants. And they rated this group of participants from 1 to 4 for who did less exercise and who did more. And they found that I'm going to give a little background. The ones that were in the 4 were actually much younger. But what happens is, our biological age is determined by our telomeres. Our telomeres are the ends of our DNA. which hold the strands together. You can think of it like the plastic on the ends of our shoestrings. Now, every time a cell divides, those get shorter and shorter until they're so short that they can't stay together and cells can't replicate anymore, so the cells just die. So when our cells can't replicate anymore, then the cells die, and then actually that is the determination of our age. How many more replications do we still have? Now, what they found is that the folks that were in the group 4 level that did more exercise, their telomeres were 59% longer than the sedentary group that did no exercise or very little exercise. So it wasn't just a little bit more exercise. The more exercise you get, biologically, the younger you are. They found that you are actually decades younger. You can be decades younger by doing lots of exercise as you age. And that group of 6,500 was aged between 45 and 65. And it was also proving that the benefits of exercise is as strong at 65 or 70 as it is much younger. And my last area that I wanted to touch on was, so how do we do this? How do we exercise? So maybe we're convinced that, hey, exercise is a good thing, and maybe we need more and more of it. But it's not easy, is it? What you have to do is you have to find things that you love. I found things that I love. I found skiing, biking, snowboarding, rock climbing. But we can all find things that we love to do. Whether it be dancing or ping pong, what we need to do is we need to find things that we love to do and build into our daily lives that involve exercise. That's all it is. And more importantly, what we need to do is we need to find things that allow us to do more and more exercise as we age. You can feel it pretty immediately. There's lots of research for it. And it is certainly very doable by finding things that you love. So I just want to leave you with this point once again. As we age, do more exercise, not less.